Want to wow your pals by knowing all about personal finance?
What's in it for me?
We can finish playing this game of Oligopoly, a board game I invented that sounds like Monopoly, but to avoid copyright infringement, it isn't. All while I fill your brain belly with info about saving and investing.
Brain belly isn't a thing.
I'm pretty sure it is. They don't call me Dr. Voiceover just for my golden voice. It's also because of my medical know-how.
Nobody calls you Dr. Voiceover.
They don't? Then what was the point of getting this neck tattoo? So why save and invest? And what different types of investments are there?
Even if I did know, I'm pretty sure you're going to tell me.
Absolutely. To put it simply, saving means putting money aside today to spend at a later date. People also save or put money aside for the future needs of their children or loved ones. Like my Toby jugs.
They're frightening.
The reason why I haven't slept in 10 years.
Understandable.
Also, saving can act as a buffer for an unexpected emergency, like the loss of a job, ill health, personal injury, or to replace expensive household items.
Or when you waste years of your life inventing a board game that already exists.
Exactly. Savings can help to build a nest egg by creating wealth through investing for financial security, especially after retirement. This could be for future spending on travel, or to buy the home you've always wanted, or for a bunker, in case the world ends, and the Toby jugs rise up and take over.
What?
Nothing, I've said too much. The greatest benefit of savings is it reduces the amount of money individuals have to borrow now or in the future.
Sounds like having a plan is ideal.
Right on. A savings plan requires individuals to be disciplined enough to set a certain amount of money aside on a regular basis to achieve a savings goal. Personally, I'm a great saver. I saved this piece of gum for 20 years by keeping it safe between my toes.
That's disgusting.
Yes, it is. A number of factors contribute to the decisions we make to spend now or to save for later, which include the amount of disposable income we have, our age, how much wealth we've already accumulated,
and how much wealth you've spent on fraudulent board games
and on Toby jugs. Another factor is whether we buy impulsively or plan carefully, and our willingness to take financial risks, for example, buying shares or starting a business. Like my latest small business, makeup for moths.
You're not very good at business, are you?
Ha, not at all. There are a number of reasons why people decide to invest, including extra income, saving for a rainy day or to make a major purchase, or to fund their retirement.
Like buying a speedboat to flee in so I never have to play Oligopoly again.
Exactly. Wait, what?
Never mind.
When we choose to invest money, we do so with the expectation that there will be some financial gain or benefit.
I take it some investment options are riskier than others?
Correct, but they might offer a greater return. Another reason to invest is saving on its own is not enough to generate more income.
You seem to have a distinct lack of savings.
Very true. Hashtag TobyJugLife. Wealth can be increased through term deposits, managed funds, investment bonds, shares, or real estate. Oh no. Guess what time it is?
What time?
It's time for DJ Investment Options! Dropping the needle on a track I like to call term deposits.
Please don't.
A term deposit is a savings product offered by a bank or other financial institution. A fixed amount of money is locked in for a fixed period to earn a fixed rate of interest. With term deposits, there is little or no risk of losing money.
And the disadvantages are?
Penalties can be imposed if the individual withdraws the money before maturity. Term deposits are less flexible than other savings products.
For instance, online savings accounts.
Excellent! Side note, financial institutions offer a range of higher interest savings accounts, which give you less access to your money than an everyday savings account, but enable you to reach a savings goal. Spin the next track, DJ Investment Options. Managed funds,
Woo yeah!
Please don't do that again.
Managed funds are when a professional fund manager pulls money from a group of investors and invests in shares or other assets to provide investors with a return on their funds.
The advantages are...
they offer diversification of investment portfolios. They give the investor access to a broader range of assets or markets with only a small cash outlay. Investors can make regular contributions. Plus, there is less paperwork, making it easier to manage for tax purposes. Which is ideal, because my tax accountant hates paperwork.
That's a badger. In a suit.
No wonder I never get a good tax return.
The disadvantages are?
Managed funds can attract higher fees than other investment options. You're relying on the skills of others to make the right investment decisions. Investors can have difficulties withdrawing their cash if it's needed in a hurry.
And you're trusting other people with your hard-earned money.
Like how my dad trusted me with his money when I persuaded him to invest in my highly original board game, Oligopoly.
How did that work out for him?
Well, I'm no longer invited to the family Christmas party. Oops. Investment bonds are offered by insurance companies and friendly societies. They lock in savings for a longer term and attract a lower tax rate in the process.
Interesting.
The advantages of investment bonds include: they are tax effective if used as a long-term investment. They offer a wider range of investment options. They can be useful for estate planning.
Go on.
They don't attract the same capital gains tax as other investment options.
The disadvantages?
For one, fees and charges. It can be a slow process to convert investment bonds to cash.
Slow like your explanations?
Exactly. Investors rely on the skills of others to make the right choices. If an investor withdraws early, then they can lose tax benefits.
Investment bonds sound like a better option than investing in a Monopoly knockoff.
That's for sure. Ha! Sorry, Dad. Miss you. Call me, please. Purchasing shares make individuals part owners of a business. They can be a risky investment if an investor is seeking short-term gains.
The advantages of shares are...
potential capital gains from owning an asset that can grow in value over time. Potential income distributed as dividends. Lower tax rates can apply on long-term capital gains.
The disadvantages?
Variability in the value and return on shares.
I suppose if a company goes belly up, then investors can lose their money.
Indeed. Also, share prices can be quite volatile. Volatile like my Toby jugs.
How can Toby jugs be volatile?
Shh, don't talk too loud. They might hear you. Property investment involves buying a residential or business property with a view to earning rental income and benefiting from the property value appreciating over time. Speaking of real estate, you've just landed on my property. That's $250 rent.
How come I have to play with real money, but you're using oligopoly money?
House rules?
The advantages of property investment are...
lower risk than some of the other investment options, rental income and capital growth. Tax deductions are possible on property expenses. Plus, you can turn anything into an investment property, like the upturned bath in my yard that I rent out to two university students.
That's not right.
Oh, I know. I could rent that space to at least three students. Another advantage is the investor owns a physical asset. And you don't really need specialized knowledge to gain entry into the property market.
The disadvantages?
There may be maintenance and other expenses that the rental income does not cover. Interest rates can fluctuate, meaning loan repayments can go up or down. If there are no tenants for a period of time, then it's not generating an income.
Or if you need to use the bathtub you rent out because you haven't washed in months.
Very true. Another disadvantage is that investment properties might take time to sell. That hurts if the investor needs quick cash. Also, you require a reasonable amount of money to invest, to buy a percentage of the property, as well as cover legal fees and stamp duty.
Speaking of risky investments, how are you going to make it up to your dad?
Well, I've got another fantastic investment opportunity that will really knock his socks off.
Not another ill-advised board game ripoff.
No, of course not. Nothing like that. This time, I've invented a highly original, word-based board game called Scrabble.
Oh, boy.
If you like this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.